Morning, everybody. Morning. Welcome to Cowichan Grace Church. Welcome to the presence of God. Yeah, it's the day to worship our God. So let's gather our heart together to worship Him and to glorify Him. Yeah. Let me just open up with prayer. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Thank you for this great privilege and honor to worship the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. What an amazing God we serve. What an amazing Savior we have. Your love, your faithfulness, and your kindness had opened the way to worship you, to have relationship with you. God, thank you, Lord. We thank you for who you are. It's the reason of our lives and songs. We are here to worship you, God. We are here to lift you up. We thank you that we have been given a voice to sing to you. So, Father, let everything in us to sing you praises forevermore. We praise you. We love you. We honor you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's sing together.
Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, where your streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name when I'm found.
Give and take away. You give and take away. Let's pray together. I really want you to come to the throne of grace now. I want you to meet our Lord Jesus Christ when you pray. Our Jesus Christ is living when He is real, and He's with you. So we want to hear His voice. That is Psalm 95. This is the Word of God. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before Him with thanksgiving. And exalt Him with music and song. For the Lord is great God, the great King above all gods. In His hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to Him. The sea is His, for He made it, and His hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down in worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for He is our God, and we are the people of His pasture, the flock under His care. Amen. When you pray to God, I want you to pray for one another, especially for the people who are lost, people who are have a difficult financial difficulties, or someone really sick. So Holy Spirit tells you in your heart, whatever He tells you, you can pray with that. And pray for the churches and all of the world. In this time, when they worship God, only our Father God receives all the glory from the churches. And when pastors preach the gospel, let them only preach the gospel, only God's word. And when you pray, Father, I want to ready to come. You're returning back soon. We want to ready. We want to discern. We want to alert in these times. So we can pray. And pray for the people who you care. Lord, let them know you, Jesus Christ. You are only our salvation. Just pray for them. And pray for this worship. Lord God, we have Cowichan Great Church. We worship you. We wait in your holy presence. We already know that you are with us. But your strong power, healing, your comfort, your love, we're waiting for you, Lord. Just pray in your faith. Let's pray together. Oh, thank you, Father God. We gather here, Father, to worship and honor your name. Yes, Lord, we bless your name forever and ever. You are so worthy to receive all our worship and honor. Oh, Father God, when we pray in this community, in our family, someone really hunger and thirst for your word. So we want to hear your word. Father, I also ask your healing to the people who are sick. Please, Father God, pour out the blood of Jesus Christ top to bottom to our beloved one, Father. Put your healing hands on them and heal them by your name, by your glory. And Father, we also pray for the some who are longing, some who are depressed, some of you are crying. Please come to them, Lord God. Jesus, let their eyes open and see that you are only our living hope, our Lord Jesus. Father, let our eyes are open and enlighten us, see that only you are living hope. So we are waiting for your returning back, Father. We are waiting for your comeback, second coming of Jesus Christ. So we want to ready. We don't want to be a foolish woman. We want to be a wise five ladies, Father God. So we want to ready your oil. Bless all our culture and your church when we worship you, Father. Your healing and your spirit come this place and fill us up with the Holy Spirit. Let us know that you are among us and we believe that two or three gather in Jesus' name. You're already here, Lord. Thank you, Father. That's why we come here and worship you, because you are among us, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Father. We want to hear your voice. Only your words cry out to your children. And thank you, whatever our church family prays in your name, Father, answer us, please, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus, for healing. Thank you, Father. Oh, Heavenly Father, we lift you all our prayer requests to your hands. Please, Father, answer us and heal us and restore us and renew our heart again. So when you, Jesus, come back, Father, we all raise our hands and gladly we welcome you, because we stand here not because of our good behavior, but because of you, our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the sacrifice in the cross. Thank you. We believe that, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Bless all our church family who worship now. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Good morning. Our God is good all the time. Amen. Our God is so good. Amen. We welcome you all in the house of God. And if we worship option, as you know, that we have worship in here. This is only option. But if you have no chance to come here, you can watch video on the YouTube. This is not a chance, but you can get together if we can. Amen. And in worship service options, masks are not mandatory, but recommended at the church. In BC, every indoor wear, you can wear the mask, but in the church, if you have health problems, you can you cannot, but it's recommended. Okay, and next Sunday, October 10th, can you believe that? October 10th already now, 2021. So I'm almost faint out. Time so flies. You know, next Sunday is Thanksgiving Sunday. We give thanks all things. You know, Pastor Joe, you know what? I have no thank in this pandemic time. No, God keep your life for great. So we give many thanks to God next Sunday, and let our family and children know that we can come together next Sunday. And then also we have an intercessory prayer meeting. Who's going to announce for this? Karen or Sybil? Anyone? Wednesday morning, 10 o'clock here, so you can pray together. So if you have any prayer request, you can put on the note on the box. Then we can pray together. And yay, we have returning back our Sunday school kids and youth. And Sunday school for kids and youth in grade 7 to 12 will return on Sunday starting next week. So this Thanksgiving Sunday, we give thanks to God because we have a Sunday school back and youth group back. So we are so excited to see you next week. So let all the children know we can have a Sunday school and youth group. Great. And we still have a Helping Hands ministry. So if you anyone that they have some need help, let them know. We can help. So I'm going to read this verse again, Hebrews 13:16. And do not forget to do good and to share with others. For with such sacrifices, God is pleased. So this is great job, Will. So let us know. We can help. Wonderful. Wonderful. And offering time, would you, Pastor Bill, and give us blessing word and prayer for the offering, please.
Father, I do thank you for the privilege of coming together today. For your word just says in very plain language, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together as the manner of some is. And Lord, it's a wonderful opportunity to be here today to worship you, to love you. Lord Jesus, you're so wonderful. And I thank you today, Lord, for my brother pastor. I ask that, Lord, you'll anoint his lips, his thoughts, as he expresses your word today, and open our Lord our ears to hear. And like that song, Lord, that we sang today, open our eyes, Lord. We want to see you. We want to see you today, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Glory, hallelujah, I shall not be moved. Anchored in Jehovah, I shall not be moved. Just like a tree that's planted by the waters, I shall not be moved. In his love abiding, I shall not be moved. And in him confiding, I shall not be moved, just like the tree that's planted by the water. I shall not be moved.
Okay, before we have a word of God and say one another in your seat, you are so beautiful, handsome, lovely, awesome, with smiles. Okay, can you say that one another? You are so beautiful, handsome, lovely, awesome. You guys are really beautiful. All right. So our today's word is settling account, the parable of talent, number two. The parable of Jesus 17-2, Matthew chapter 25, verse 24 to 28. If you have a Bible, open the Bible, Matthew 25, 24 to 28. If you have no chance to bring the Bible, you can read together this. Go. Then he who had received the one talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. And I was afraid, and went and hid your talent in the ground. Look there, you have what is yours. What is yours? But his Lord answered and said to him, you wicked and lazy servant, you knew that I reap where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered seed. So you ought to have deposited my money with the bankers, and at my coming I would have received back my own with interest. Therefore, take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. Everyone says, amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you, Lord God, the Logos, your word, is God and our Lord Jesus Christ. So, Father, in this moment, Father, you through me, share your word to your children. Our Lord Jesus Christ, living one. So when we listen your word, anoint our eyes and ears and heart So, Father, let us enlighten our heart to see your glory through this message. And, Father, we want to walk with you every single moment. And thank God you gave us talent, whatever that is. We're going to make great talent with obedience. Thank you, Father God. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, the parable of the talent. Do you know this story, right? Who is this one? Goliath. About this? David. David is a little boy at the time, and Goliath 3 meters in the Bible. And you know what? Before they fight, King Saul heard that the little boy want to fight with this big giant. So King Saul asked him, okay, I'm so worried about you. You're a little boy. You're really little boy. You're weak. You're too small. But you know what? This Goliath, when he was young, he's a strong warrior. At the time, David, little boy, said to King Saul, you know what, king? I'm a shepherd, little shepherd. I took care of our sheep. But one day, the wolf and bear and lions comes. I beat them up and save my just a little lamb. And after that, he said this. We're going to read together 1 Samuel 17:37. Go. Moreover, David said, the Lord who delivered me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear, he will deliver me from the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said to David, go, and the Lord be with you. Amen. He has what? He has Lord God. So when he take care of the sheep, little lamb, he fight with the enemies, he always with Lord. His testimony about this situation, my Lord did it. King Saul heard that, wow, even though you are little, you have God. So what he said that? And Saul said to David, go, okay, you can fight with the Goliath. Go and the Lord be with you. You know what? The little boy, David, he take care of his really good work, even tiny little job. Then God gave him a great job as a king. So last Sunday, we talked about someone got a 5 talent, other servant 2 talent. They double up with this from the Lord. And the Lord praised them. Like 10 talent and 5 talent, I mean 4 talent, and still he has 1 talent. And when Lord saw them, the master said to them, his Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. What did he say that? Well done, good and faithful servant. Good. And next word touches my heart. You were faithful. You were so faithful over a few things. Sometimes we're waiting. Lord, if you bless me, if you give me lots of money, I can share to poor people. You can give me smart brain. I can be a doctor and help people. If you give me many things, then I can serve you better. But what is this one? David and the Lord said to them, good and faithful servant, you were faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord. Amen. What about you? Do you have power, talent, ability, any skills, knowledge? Compared to somebody else, I'm so, My talent is tiny. When I play guitar compared to Anna, Pastor Anna, I'm really like a beginner. So I hate Anna. This is right? No, this is not right. Sometimes we compare and complaining about what you have, what we have. I hate her because she's better than me. She's great guitar player, and the voice so beautiful. I hate her. You know, sometimes our reaction is really like that. Compared to someone else, I don't like them. I don't like her. I don't like him. He's better. He has lots of money. God, I'm so angry with you because I have a little talent and they have lots of great talent. Maybe this, the one who has one talent, returning back, when the Lord returning back, he just gave one talent. Because he, digging up the ground, and from the one talent down there, when he heard the Lord's come back, he digging up again, because maybe he angry. Oh, I don't like my master. It's my friend. He's same as me, or sometimes less. Why, Lord, the master gave to 5 talents and 2 talents, only me, just 1 talent. I don't like my master and my friends. I envy them. Maybe he angry, and he put on the ground. Sometimes we compare. And when you compare to someone else, it's in your heart, grudge, angry, or complaining against God and people and world, and sometimes inferiorism. I'm not better. I'm nobody. I'm loser. This kind of severe inferiorism make people angry or sometimes depressed. Sometimes when you the depress is deeper and deeper, you don't want to do anything. Get lazy. Want to sleep and sleep over and over and sleep. I don't do anything. I don't want to do anything. No. I hate world. I hate God and I hate my friends. He got everything, but not me. You know, this kind of inferiorism, if you not deal with this, this inferiorism eats you up. You know, Moses. Moses, he's an excellent man. He was saved by God. He's supposed to die like other Hebrew boys. But God saved him. But in 40 years, in his golden 40 years in his Egyptian kingdom, he was raised. He knows everything. He's smart. And he is well known everything and well treated by people. But he finally knew that I am not real prince of this land. And in his house, my real mom talk about Hebrews. And my real mom talk about God, Jehovah. But when I go to Egyptian palace, they talk about other gods, other language, other culture. So sometimes he didn't know who he was. So and an inferiorism in his heart, and he has anger. So with his anger, he punched the Egyptian man and he died. And he knew that if I kill the Egyptian man, all my brothers and sisters and my blood, they encourage me and they let me king of the Hebrews, but nobody encouraged him. Instead of them, they judge him. So he fled to the wilderness. And after 40 years beautiful life and 40 years later in the wilderness until his age 80. So people thought, 80? Okay, you're ready for retire. Actually, retire language from French. You end your job and rest your life, enjoy. Maybe that is a retire. But in English, re-tire. When you drive, tire is worn out. You can come on, switch the brand new tire, re-tire again. You can drive back for your golden life. So no more retired. I thought that is a real English. I don't know. Retire, right? You know, this Moses, after 80, in his heart, his comparison to other people, I'm so not happy. I'm nothing. I'm already loser for 40 years, and nobody helped me, nobody supported me, nobody for me. And at his age 40, what happened? The burning bush, when he was a shepherd, God met him, and God said to him, go back to Egypt. With this inferiorism, with this depression, with this laziness, what is the response to God? Oh, thank you, Lord. You give a second chance. You give me a retire for my life again. Great. He didn't say that. No, he didn't give thanks to God. He said, no, God, I'm not worthy. I have no power. I have no talent. No, I couldn't even speak. No way. What he said, please send someone else to do that. Send someone else to do that. If you think about your talent is less, like this one man who has one talent and digging the ground and returning back the Lord, and this is yours. You have no greatness in your heart. Always angry. Always laziness. God knows Moses. Finally, God sent him as he is. And he did a great job because he obey the word of God, and God always with him. God always with him. You know, what is the main concept, main idea of this, the parable of talent? What is that? How much we got from Lord, or how much we got left from Lord? That is not main point. The important thing is, whatever God gives, we obey and faithful. I'm shorter than someone else. With your shorter status, you can do great job. If you have no money than someone else, with that tiny little money, you can do great job. But this talent, the parable of talent, people think about only 5 talent and 2 talent. Compared to them, I just 1 talent. You know, as a pastor, you know, I really want to confess that. I don't do anything really good. I'm really not skillful. My wife knows it. Kelly knows that. If I do the carpenter job, I've broken many things. Yeah, I don't know. And I have no skill at all. And then, car mechanic things, I'm trying to, but it's broken again. And art, no, I don't know art. The music, yeah, a little bit. I can play guitar, that's all. I used to be good at computer, but you know what, technology is really fast. I'm really old-fashioned now, even nowadays, even computer. About sports, I don't really do good sports. So even in the military service, when they have a military soccer, they choose. I'm the last one. Why? Because nobody want me to be a soccer player in that. If I be there, that team is lose. So nobody want me. I'm really sad. You know what? I don't know my talent. Okay. Your pastor, as your pastor, you preach the gospel. Good, if that is talent compared to my friend ministered 1,000 people, I'm really thankful about 20 people in the house. You know, I don't know how much fruit I bear, but I don't know. But one thing I know, I obey faithfully whatever God says. Whether our church member comes as one person, or 20, or 70, or 100, it doesn't matter. I stand here, share the gospel. If I obey, somebody stand, make them stay here and preach the gospel. That is my job. Even though compared to my friend, it's a little tiny, but I faithfully obey what God gave this talent. You know what? Sometimes we misunderstand. If we do great job or biggest job, maybe God praise me. No. Tiny things. When you read Matthew chapter 25, the next parable is about when king come, separate sheep and goat. Then all they say that, king say to the right side, the lambs, and he said, thank you. When I'm hungry, you give me food. When I'm hungry, you give me fried bread. Thank you. When I'm hungry, king said, you give me Tim Hortons coffee. Thank you. When I'm in prison, you visit me. When I'm in hospital, you come and pray. The righteous one on the right side, they said, when, Lord, I didn't treat you, Lord. Then he said, that what did king say to them? Matthew 25:40, the king will reply, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of least of these brothers of mine, you did for me. For the left one goat, you did not provide anything. You did not feed me. You did not give me any drink water. When, Lord? When? Exactly the same thing. You didn't provide or you didn't help any one of this list of these brothers of mine. You know, we are really thankful that God didn't ask you. God doesn't ask you the biggest work. No, just tiny work. Just tiny work. Because if you clean your vessel, God uses you. Bible said that. 2 Timothy chapter 2:20, but in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor. Sometimes people thought I'm dishonor. I'm like a wood vessel or clay vessel. I'm not valuable than someone else who are so beautifully aware and well educated, and they seem like a gold and silver. But what does God said? Some are for honor and some for dishonor. To whom? Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from the latter, he will be a vessel for honor. What is the main point of this vessel? You are gold or silver or clay or wood? It doesn't matter. It's honorable, the vessel. You are cleansed or not? Your heart is cleansed by Holy Spirit or not? The appearance, you're beautiful and gold and silver, God never use you if you have no cleanness by the blood of the Lamb. Will be best for honor, sacrificed and useful for the Master, our Lord God, prepare for every good work. Then am I cleansed? I really want to be honored by God. I want to be honored by our God, Creator God. Are you cleansed? Yes. What did Jesus say? That John 15:2. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, He prunes that it may bear more fruit. Next verse. We can read together. Go. You are already clean because of word which I have spoken to you. Amen. Amen. If you hear the word of God and Jesus saying to you, you hear and say amen and you obey, what is that? You are already cleaned. When the word of God say that if you believe the blood of Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sin and he resurrected for your life, do you believe that? Yes, I believe that. Yes, I do. You, because of his word spoken to you, you are already what? Clean. This is word of God. So you are so already honorable vessel. Our maker want to use you for his glory. His glory. Amen. Amen. So sometimes, oh, pastor, you know what? In the church, nothing I can do. I'm not good cook. It's okay. I have no money to provide any food. It's okay. When you sit in the church, nobody replaces your seat. Your seat in here is a blessing seat. You just to sit in the worship, that is a blessing. You feel with your love, with your prayers, with your worship, and fill this place together as one brothers and one sister by the Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes compared, our talents is little. Nobody praise my talent. But we should know that this is a blessing from God. Nothing we can proud of our talent because of tiny. That's why we can only rely on our God alone. Lord God, my talent is really tiny compared to someone else. So with my ability, I cannot do this work. So I rely on you, Lord, alone. Only you, Father God. So we should remember this talent. This is great grace God give you each and everyone's talent. But sometimes we don't know his grace, his love. We're just burying the great talent under the ground. What is the Lord said to him? So you ought to have deposited my money with the bankers. And at my coming, I would have received back my own with interest. What is that? Talent, how big is that? Maybe sometimes we thought that talent is one coin. No, it's not one coin. This is big gold. Do you know how much that is? 34 kilograms. 20 million dollars. Someone said 1 million, but mostly in the gold nowadays and 20 million. God gave each and every just tiny things. Then what is my 20 million? My life. More valuable than 20 million. And God gave families. God gave all kind of talent in your life. But this man, he never gave thanks to about his gold and 20 million. He just complaining. He never grateful to God's greatness. And instead of give thanks, he angry to God. And he say like it's bad language, actually. This is kind of very, very bad. Maybe we can read together. This is the one talented man say, then he who had received the one talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. Do you know what that means? Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where we have not sown, reaping where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed? What is that? You're really evil man. That's why I just put on the ground. You know what the meaning? Meaning is, I'm going to give you illustration. How much this one? $10, $10. Really big money. I just give to Anna. Pastor Anna, would you give some errand for me? Then she said, yes. With this $10, you can buy steak. You can buy one chicken. You can buy 5 hamburgers. And you can give me back my changes, $20. Can you do that? Just $10 and you can do a great job. You know, this man thought, oh, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered seed. He didn't know his own Lord, this master. I'm very interesting. 5 talent with a 10 talent. Where is the money goes? Where the $10 goes? To the master's house? No. To the servant. 2 talents for 4 talents? To the servant. And next verse you can read that. Therefore, take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. You know, the goal of this master is the money. Making lots of money? No. His real goal is what? He was so pleased to see his servant bear lots of fruit for themselves. Like a parent, if their children success, we see them. That is great honor. My children grow well. You grow well and you can lots of money and give to me forever? No, that is not parents. He didn't know his master. He's just afraid and just buried under the ground. What is the Bible says? After a long time, the Lord of those servants came and settled account with them. One day, they settled account with them. Because this talent is not ours. Our life is not ours. Our money account is not ours. Our car, house is not ours. Our guitar skills and music and art and everything is not ours. It's from God. This belongs to God. And one day he will come back and settle the account with us. Then what are you going to give to God? Lord, I bury it. Compared to someone else, my skill is really tiny, so I'm just buried. Maybe Pastor Joy preached the gospel. I don't need to share the gospel to my friend. You know, what is the settling account? God gave us beautiful life, beautiful talent, ability. But when Jesus come back, if you just under the ground, you bury with your body. This is so sad. You know, this is very important word. C.T. Studd. This is a sincere servant of God, and he said that only one life. It will soon be passed. Only what is done for Christ will last. Maybe this one talent man, he did a great job under the bearing the master's money, master's talent under the ground. He worked hard, I don't know. Maybe he worked hard for himself. For himself. His own work. Not God's work. His own work. Only one life. It will soon pass. It will soon pass. You know that. Only what is done for Christ will last. So with our talents from God, we can bear fruit. Because we are already cleansed by His word. So we give glory. Amen? Let's pray. Father, thank you, Lord God. C.T. Studd said, only one life. Yes, Lord, our life is just one life, but everlasting life. It will soon be passed in this life. But only what is done for Christ will last. Yes, Lord. So until you come back, we want to bear fruit, your talent, not our job, not good things for our own goods. So, Father, bless all our Cowichan and Great Church family who listen to your word. So we want to obey. We not complain compared to someone else's. With our talent, we give all the glory. We just share. We want to share and we want to help just a little tiny our friends and brothers and sisters. So when Jesus come back, well done. You did a great job with these tiny things. Father, bless all our church family who listen to your word. And thank you, Father, your word this morning. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and love of Father God and fellowship of Holy Spirit be with you all forever and ever. Everyone says, amen, amen.